if I may, point out that Alex Ovechkin is one goal away from scoring his 30th of the season in his 14th season. In the history of the National Hockey League, Mike Gartner is the only player to do that. Only, ever, 14 times 30. The great eight, his greatness never even in doubt. So let me turn to you two and ask your reaction. Billy, you first. In support of or against this decision by Ovi?
Fully supporting this decision by Ovechkin. He played all those games last year. That's a heavy toll on the body. And the first and main focus is to win a Stanley Cup. That's what you want to do. So you have to do everything that you think is right to prepare yourself to win a Stanley Cup. Last year, Ovechkin was marvelous in the playoffs. He plays a very physical game, a very heavy game, a very energetic game. That takes a lot out of a body, especially at the age of 33. The NHL All-Star Game has turned into a glorified scrimmage. You see the stars out there, they just kind of go through the motions. When I played, I loved that week break. I would go somewhere nice, go down to the Florida Keys, put my toes in.
All-Star game?
No,
is that,
never.
For clarification.
Never.
You played in the All-Star
game? In Bantam hockey, yes, in Bantam hockey.
Right.
So we'll get past that. But Bantam hockey, I played in the All-Star game. But go somewhere. I went down, put my toes in the sand, and relaxed. And I loved it. Got rejuvenated and felt better once you got going back into the hockey, got refocused, kind of. Got the juices back. Players, so it's the stage. But Ovechkin's been there before. They've seen him. Everyone knows what Alex Ovechkin's about. I love this, that you're putting the Stanley Cup first and foremost. That's what it's all about in the NHL. The All-Star game is just a side part of it. The fans, whatever.
It is, Billy, if you can justify the rest, though. I mean, for me, it starts here, Tony. There is a duty. There is an obligation if you're a mediocre player, if you're a fourth-line Hammond Egger, or if you're Alex Ovechkin. You give to the game at these moments because if those that are like Ovechkin, those that are All-Stars, fail to show up, it kind of undermines the entire concept of the All-Star game. And this is kind of a signature event for the league.
Get rid of it.
Well,
I'm okay with that.
That's a completely separate discussion, though. Yeah. It's a completely separate discussion. It's on the calendar. It's a vibrant part of the schedule today. But here's the thing. If it's rest that he needs, I'm all for that. I just don't see that, though. I mean, this guy's got 29 goals in his first 38 games this year. Billy, he's on pace to have a career year. If he were suffering from fatigue, we'd have seen something. We'd see some indication of that to this point. And the other point is this. I'm looking at that portion of the schedule right now. January 25, 26, 27, that's your All-Star obligation. There are still four dates before the Washington Capitals face off against the Calgary Flames on the back end of that. There's plenty of rest right there contained in the All-Star break for him to have that break. And add to it, there's, in today's NHL, four mandated days off per month in addition to that which Todd Reardon would want to give him over and above that. Just take the maintenance days. There, if it's rest that he needs, he could find that rest without any trouble. He's a star. He's one of the premier stars of the game. He ought to be there.
If there's fatigue, he's in his longest goal drought of the season at this very moment.
I don't see fatigue, though. I don't see fatigue.
If it's going there, but if you get there, the All-Star game to me has turned into just a preliminary scrimmage anyway. Well, I'm not a fan of the format
actually,
and the scrimmage. Let the guys rest.
You're actually making the point. So,
but you're still playing hockey.
So he goes, he straps
on the pads. Get yourself away from hockey.
He shuffles around on the ice for a little bit. That's not the equivalent of a 60-minute NHL contest. It's nowhere close to that.
But get your head away
from
the
All-Star game itself contains the rest he needs.
Talk to the majority of the players. Yeah. They enjoy the break.
Yeah.
100%.
I don't disagree. And I appreciate the part about the mental vacation. I'm saying there are still opportunities for him to get that rest and that mental separation from the game to rejuvenate himself. If that's what he needs, I don't see it. I don't see it. So to me, it's a shame. And especially, our fans have voted Alex one of the captains to the Metropolitan Division. It's a shame that he can't make it. It really is. I don't recall Wayne begging out of that.
Mm. But the All-Star game was back. It was different, too. It was competitive back then. Had a lot of juice to it. It
Great.
Did, somewhat. Compared to what
game?
We see now, 3-on-3 hockey, moving around with 15 to 11 scores.
That's a separate discussion.
Okay.